Okay, so you received your party mate and you're ready to assemble it. So I just wanted to make a quick instructional video on how to put this thing together to make sure that we've got it all set up right. But first and foremost, we want to make sure that we've got all the parts necessary to do that. So it's nothing worse than getting through it and not having the part that you need to finish completing it. So we're going to go over those parts individually here. And what we've got first and foremost is the left lower arm, and that's labeled. We have the right lower arm, that's also labeled, it's got a little sticker on it. We've also got a hitch pin. We have what's called a plunger pin that's going to allow you to adjust the party mate up and down. We've also got swivel brackets that are labeled left and right. That's going to help you know which arms to put those on. With those, you're going to have two bolts. These bolts are going to allow you to attach the tables to these swivel brackets. Okay. An important piece here is the tongue. This is going to fit into your receiver hitch. We've also got two S arm bends, and you want to make sure that these have these pop pins in the ends of them, okay? Those are important. That's going to allow it to lock when you're driving. We have a license plate bracket. This license plate bracket should have a bolt that's in it, nut on one end, washer, lock washer. Lastly, we have our tabletops. Now, the hinges are already attached to the tabletops, so make sure that you've got each table with a hinge underneath it. And from there, once you've got all the important parts, what we're going to do is put this thing together. Okay, so you are going to need a couple tools to assemble the tailgate party mate. You're going to need a half inch socket wrench or an adjustable wrench will work fine. Now you need an 8mm Allen wrench and a 5mm Allen wrench. That's all you're going to need to put this thing together. I like to start with it in the hitch because it actually holds it while you're trying to put it together. It makes it a little bit easier. So that's the first thing you're going to want to do. Okay, the second thing you're going to want to do is take the lower right arm, it's labeled, and you're just going to slide it right up into the receiver. And then you're going to take your plunger pin and go ahead and screw that in and make sure it's, you know, through one of the adjustment holes on the side to make sure once it's all the way tightened, it securely fastens all this into place, so it makes it more sturdy, like that. So that's step number two. Okay, for step three, we're going to take the lower left arm. I should make this point, when you're facing the back of the truck, that's going to determine what's left and right. So, facing the back of the truck, this is the lower left, we're going to slide this one in to place. And we do have the license plate holder. Some folks, you check on your own state law, but if you do want to use the license plate holder, it simply just slips over the top and the bolt goes through like there. For right here, just to show you guys how this is going to work, we're just going to put the pin in right here, like this. And then fasten it with the bolt behind it. Okay, so the fourth step, we want to take our S arm bends and we just set them on top, push in the little pop pin, and just slides right down on. It doesn't matter which side they go on because these pieces are identical, so all you're going to want to do is just set those right on top, like that. Darken everything around me. Call the clouds. Okay, step number five, what I like to do is just lay the tables flat, and then we're going to take these swivel brackets, the ones that are marked left and right, and you're going to line up this little cutout here with the cutout that's set up on the hinge. So you can kind of see it right there, it just fits right into it perfectly. That's where we're going to take our bolt, put it in there, and just tighten it up like so. Use our 8mm Allen wrench, make sure it's good and snug. And we're going to do the same thing for the left bracket. So we're going to make sure we line this up. That little pin there. Put the screw in. And then just tighten it up. Alright. Okay, once we've got our swivel brackets securely attached to our table hinges, what we're going to do is just make sure you know which one's right and which one's left. And I just like to flip them open like this. And there's a little magnet post on here that's gonna hold the table down when you're driving down the road. That's why we put that on there. So once you flip them down, We're gonna pick up our right and left one. This one happens to be the right. So we're gonna go ahead and we're just gonna set it right on top of these end posts. Press in the pop pin and it should slide right down onto it. We're gonna do the same thing with our left one. Set it right down on the top. Push in the pop pin, and slide right down. If the tables are on correctly, you're gonna notice that the Tailgate Partymate logo is at the top of the table. Now all you need to do is just close it up. All the pop pins will lock into place and secure the tables in the closed and locked position, just like that. So when it's all assembled, this is exactly what it should look like.